What is a TFC motor? What environments can I use it in? I'll be answering that plus more right after this. Hey guys, Kelly from Torpy Denver, your online resource for industrial power transmission and automation applications. Hit the subscribe button so you guys don't miss any of our upcoming videos. At the end of the video, we're going to be doing our Torpy tip of the day, which is going to be explaining how to identify a single phase motor versus a three phase motor. And can you answer that question before we get to the end of the video? Throw it in the comment section and see if you're right. So TEFC stands for Totally Enclosed Fan Cooled Motor. And really what those are is it's totally enclosed like these two motors are. There's no way any kind of, debris, contaminants can get inside this enclosure because it's completely sealed. You'll also notice that there's a fan on the end. This is actually the fan cover. Let me flip one of these around here. I'm hoping you can see this, but if I'm twisting the output shaft, and you should be able to see the fan turning inside there. And what this is doing is it's actually forcing air up and around the motor to try to pull the heat away from the motor, and that's how these motors cool themselves. They will also have small drain holes on the bottom of the motor, and that is so if condensation builds up inside the enclosure that they'll be able to drain. So when you see those, don't think that there's a bolt missing. Those are meant to be there. And really the basic differences between these motors and let's say your more popular industrial motors like the ODP, which is open drip proof motor, and your TENV motor, which is totally enclosed non-ventilated motor. The ODP is going to have vents along the enclosure, so it's an open enclosure so debris can get inside the motor, and that'll be a quick way for you to be able to identify that type of motor in your facility. Totally enclosed non-ventilated motor isn't going to have a fan. It's just going to be a totally enclosed enclosure. And those motors typically don't go any higher than a 5 horse. But don't be surprised if you do see some that are a little bit higher. We at Torpy Denver, about 80% of the time, use totally enclosed fan-cooled motors for most of our applications. The reason being is that they are just very versatile motors. Or enclosures, I should say. A lot of industrial environments are dirty, dusty, there's a lot of contaminants in the air. These are great motors in dirty environments. And a bonus is these motors can be outside. They can withstand the environments of wind, rain, and cool weather. These are Baldor motors, and Baldor does have a great program where you can modify the motors called Mod Express. So let's say you do have your motor outside and it's cold and you need to make sure it starts. They can add heaters to them. They can also add thermal protection to them. They can add encoders to the shafts. There's multiple different options to modify these motors. And I'll throw a link in the description area to their website. I also will throw a link in to the Baldor catalog. If you guys ever have any questions, throw them in the comment section. Love to answer them. So now we're gonna get to our Torpy tip of the day. How do you identify a single phase motor versus a three phase motor? And were you guys able, just by looking at these motors, identify which one is a single phase motor? If you said the white one is a single phase motor, you're actually correct. The gold one is actually a three phase motor. And the telltale sign you look for is a conduit box like this on the motor. Reason being, there's actually a capacitor that can actually start the motor through the single phase. And that's going to be our Torpy tip of the day. And guys, don't forget, if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and hit that red subscribe button or the bell notification so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos.